Hello and welcome to this exam question video. Today we're looking at AQA GCSE and we've got these questions here 19 or more specifically 19.1. We'll look at 19.2 later on, but for this one we're looking at the planes and axes where the arm is bending at the elbow in figure 4. So we've got a tennis player here who's going from a forehand preparation phase through to the execution phase. So before we answer any sort of question like this, we first need to identify what sort of joint action is occurring, and then we always take it back to anatomical position to assess whether or how the planes and axes are being used or are involved in that movement. Anatomical position obviously being with our feet and palms facing forward, hands down by our side, head looking forwards. So it's that open position with palms facing forward and toes facing forward. Not too dissimilar to how this tennis performer is actually standing. But what we'll do, we'll look at the elbow, look at the joint action, and then we'll quickly run through what I've got open at the bottom here, is the slide from the lesson presentation from inside the portal on planes and axes. So, movement at the elbow. We know that the elbow, we've got a hinge joint, so only two actions can occur, and that is flexion and extension. So in order to work out what sort of plane and axes, we can look at this action and determine if it's flexion or extension. So if this person is going from preparation through to the execution phase, we've got an extended joint to start with, followed by a decreased joint, so we know that flexion is occurring at the elbow. So if we now take that into anatomical position and sort of replicate flexion at the elbow, very similar to a bicep curl movement, bringing those fists or palms up from beside our pockets, up towards our shoulder, decreasing that angle at the joint. So now we need to determine which plane and axes flexion at the elbow occurs in. Now with a plane, we're looking for a parallel movement. We're looking for that windscreen wiper action where the limb or the bone would be wiping that surface of the plane, so it's moving parallel to it. The axes, on the other hand, is the perpendicular line, almost that metal pin or pole, that imaginary axis which, if we were to spin or turn that axis, it would cause that rotational event to occur. Just like the Earth spins on the axis that runs from north to south pole, if we were to turn both ends of that axis, then the Earth would spin, it would rotate in that direction. It would move, east to west. So, with flexion of the elbow, we're looking at the frontal axis, because that axis is going across the joint, allowing for forwards and backwards movement. So a nice way to remember that is the F, the frontal axis, allows for forwards and backwards movement. And we know that the joint action of flexion is when our hand, or which is down by our pockets, our hand is being flexed, or our elbow is flexing, therefore our hands are coming forwards from our body. If we were to then put the arm back to our body, then it would be going backwards. So forwards and backwards movements from anatomical position occur around the frontal axes. Now it's always going to be the same plane. Planes and axes work in pairs. So whenever you've got an axis, then you're always going to have the same perpendicular plane to it. A nice way to sort of remember that or to work through it in your head is to get a pen and a spare piece of paper, stab it through the middle, and then you can just sort of tilt it, almost like a spinning top, just tilt it around until you work out which pair of axes and planes you're dealing with. So we know that we're dealing with the blue, we've got the frontal axes because we've got that forwards and backwards rotation at flexion at the elbow, and it's the sagittal plane because that splits our body or limb down the midline. So it splits us into our sides, our left and right hand sides. So the sagittal plane, the S for sides, the frontal axis for forwards and backwards, those two together will allow for flexion at the elbow from the preparation to the execution phase of a tennis forehand. Now this question could ask you for any joint, any sort of action, any sort of sporting context. What you need to do is be able to take that sporting movement back to anatomical position and then assess the joint action in anatomical position. So even though here, technically, the axes would be sort of going from north to south or top to bottom through the elbow, and the arm would be sort of flexing like this, like a door, we would take that joint action to anatomical position down by our side and then assess it from there. So that's that. We have our sagittal plane and frontal axes causing flexion in the elbow in the execution part of a tennis forehand. So I hope it helped, and I'll see you again in the next one. Bye for now.